Let me follow up on the your time at Commerce. There was a legislative audit report that came out 2006-2007. Mm-hmm. I don't remember exactly when. I believe covered part of your time there. Mm-hmm. And it was scathing. It looked at these enormous number of programs that weren't well coordinated, that weren't well monitored, and it recommended some changes. Mm-hmm. Were you aware of those issues, and what did you do to try to fix them? And then, as a follow-up to that, one of the answers that the Walker administration had was the Wisconsin Economic Development Corp, which we have now. Is that an improvement?
Mm-hmm. Well, I used the audit report to say, yeah, we have to address these issues. And the fact is that it covered a small amount of time that I had been at Commerce. And so it was a tool to say, yeah, we have to look at our processes and our systems. We also have to work with the legislature, because one of the main findings of that report was how many different programs there are over how many different organizations.
Created
by legislature. Right. But that's also why that I see as governor that I'm going to elevate the whole role of economic development that is right in the governor's office. Because when you just assign it to an agency like WEDEC, or whether it was Commerce at that point, the fact is, to have significant change in the long term, you have to take this clusters approach that I have identified in my jobs plan. You have to engage education. You have to engage industry. You have to engage the regulatory areas. You have to engage city and local governments as well, and the nonprofit community. So you need to have this be a much higher level than an agency that is over
and
here.
And WEDC, is that
and
working?
So, no. Absolutely not. If you look at
just... So would you get rid of it?
No, I'd make it work. And I'm not going to take the energy or the focus off of creating jobs by looking at changing the form. Mm-hmm. What I look at is whether it's being effective or not. You've seen changeovers in, I think, 8 different leadership hires there. That's always a sign in any organization. If you have that many changes in such a short period of time, something's not working. We've seen them lose track of taxpayer dollars. We've seen recently not even using the funds expended, $30 million that wasn't even used. You see grants being given with no expectation of job creation, not even an expectation of job retention. $6 million and a company can lay off half their workforce? That's not right. I am definitely going to make changes.
So it's more
changes.
Function, not form in your
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But then I am also going to have economic development actually have a higher level that has a more encompassing approach to the entire, not only state government, but state organization as well.
If you bring economic development right into the governor's office, don't you have a chance to have pay to play or other bad things happen, that things could be more political if that's the case?
Not in my administration, absolutely not.
How do you avoid that?
It's the tone and the expectations that you set. And I'm going to set the expectations from day one that we are going to be an incredibly high ethics administration. I'm not going to put up with any of the nonsense in terms of that type of thing in my administration. It's just it's the way I have run my life, and it's the way I've run organizations that I have been in charge of, and it's the way I'm going to run the state.